sensational poulet, le perfect way. Cooking perfection on Ireland AM. Brought to you by Dodytrish.
Welcome back. It's Chinese New Year today. This year, it's the year of the rat. But you know what? We're going to avoid rats in the kitchen this morning. With any luck.
Yes, definitely. Instead, we have a much more palatable pork and prawn dumplings instead. And Eva Paugh from Dublin's Chinese New Year Festival, which is taking place in the capital across the whole weekend, is joining us. Eva, good morning,
morning
to you once
Eva.
Again. And a happy Chinese New Year to
Thank
you.
Thank you.
So a very traditional Chinese dish to celebrate today.
Exactly. So you traditionally would bake this on the New Year's Eve.
Okay.
So last night. And then you make it, you start boiling them at midnight. So it's a good kind of a symbol because the shape of them is like Chinese ingots, like kind of money. So like old ancient money.
I didn't realize
so,
there's a correlation.
Symbolism
so
to it as
so
well.
So it brings like prosperous like New Year if you make it just on the New Year's Eve.
Okay, so across China at midnight people would be cooking and throughout the world indeed in the Chinese community. Okay, so the ones you're doing today have pork.
Prawn and chive. So I'm going to start by making the wrapper. So to make the wrapper, you need flour. And I've got a dumpling flour here. And you can use plain flour if you don't have dumpling flour. But the dumpling flour is just gives the dough a bit more stretchiness when you're kind of making the wrapper.
Mm.
So you combine the dough. It's one part flour to half part water.
Okay.
So I've used 500 grams of flour to 250 mils of water. I've combined it into a nice dough. And once you combine it to a dough, you leave it to proof for about 15-20 minutes.
In the fridge or
room
temperature?
Room temperature. Okay. And then you roll it out into a kind of like a long sausage shape like I have here. And then you start kind of cutting it into kind of 2 cm pieces. Okay?
Easy enough so far.
Yeah. And then you kind of roll it into like a nice little kind of a ball so that when you kind of flatten it, it becomes like a nice kind of a round shape.
Mm.
And that will give your wrapper a really nice kind of a round wrapper.
Once you roll it out.
Exactly.
Okay.
So then I'm going to show you quickly how to roll it, which is just you kind of push your kind of rolling pin in.
That's the cutest rolling pin I've ever seen.
It is a mini one. It's just easier to manage and roll the dumpling wrapper. So you kind of just roll it to the thickness that you want.
Okay, that's pretty perfect. Can you cut around it if it's a little bit less?
I guess you could use a cutter.
Cutter.
You could use a round cutter, couldn't you?
Okay, yeah,
you
perfect could. Shape. All right.
But you can also buy kind of pre-made ones if you want. So there's pre-made dumpling wrappers.
Mm.
Yeah. So, okay. So are you going to... Actually, you know what? I'm going to make the filling next.
Oh, great.
So you make the wrapper and then the filling.
Okay.
So then I've got some minced pork, minced prawn, and some Chinese chives. I'm just going to grab the bowl here. And so I'm just going to show you how to combine it all. So in the bowl, I'm just going to add some of the minced pork.
Okay.
Okay. And then minced prawn is just kind of raw prawns kind of chopped really finely.
Okay.
So you add in some minced prawn and then you season it before you add in the vegetables. So the vegetables, I've got Chinese chives here and they're also known as kind of a garlic chive.
And what would be a good alternative?
Kind of Chinese cabbage or you could use celery.
Okay, great.
Or mushrooms.
Finely chopped.
Yeah. So I'm going to just add some kind of seasonings to this mixture. Sorry.
So what seasonings do we have?
So I've got a little bit of sesame oil. A little bit of sesame oil, and then I add some salt.
You're only using a tiny amount, but
very
I suppose
tiny,
it's quite moist, isn't it, the meat?
The sesame oil has quite a strong flavor, so you don't want to add too much of it in.
And what's this?
This is the Chinese cooking wine. So when I'm marinating meats and kind of, I would definitely add a little bit of the Shaoxing cooking wine in.
And is that readily available in supermarkets around the country or
probably
the Asian markets?
Asian supermarkets.
Okay. And likewise for the dumpling flour and... Mm.
Exactly,
specifically ingredients.
I cheated. I bought the ones already made, rolled.
Okay, so you've had a go at this.
Yes, I made them before and we all loved them, but I made such a mess in the kitchen. So I think you'd have to make them a few times to sort
and
of
did
hone
you make
your
them
talent.
From scratch with the...
I bought the dumplings already rolled and probably put too much in, so I can't wait to see how much
Eva puts
in.
Okay, so I've just added a little bit of sugar and some white pepper.
Okay.
And to combine it, you just add some cornstarch. So do you know, or else the filling will kind of break.
Okay, so this is going to bind it.
Bind it, exactly.
Gotcha.
So
maybe that's where I went wrong, because it was oozing out the sides, which didn't look very... as nice as they should do.
So, combining...
Sounds delicious, Laura.
But it tasted good. So you're combining them all.
Combining this will take quite like a good few minutes because you can sometimes use my hands to
I was going to say, can you get stuck in? Because we're working with the chopsticks here.
Because, and then basically after you've combined that, I'd spend like about 3-4 minutes kind of combining it and then you add the kind of the Chinese chives.
Right.
And then you kind of...
So veggies for the last minute.
Yeah, exactly. But I've got one here that's kind of made up.
Oh, good. So we can leave this aside for the moment.
Exactly. So you can see that it's quite a paste like that. You need to really combine it for a good few minutes.
There's a lovely smell, from the...
The garlic chives.
The garlic chives, yeah.
So, okay, now we're going to try and wrap some. So, okay. Would you like to try?
I'd love to, yeah.
Okay.
Aiden, you should try as well.
Mom.
There's only room for one. You crack on. I'll watch and learn.
Okay, so...
Is the key then how much, and can people at home see that, how much of the mixture we're going to put in the middle?
Okay, so in one hand you put your wrapper and then you kind of add some filling. That's a little bit too much filling, so... Okay.
In the middle.
Then you can kind of stretch it a little bit and then kind of pinch it in the middle and then pinch it to the two sides and then kind of... Pinch it all together.
Fold it.
Yeah, fold it together. So the thing is, you really want to make it so that none of the, it's kind of really nicely combined so that no water can get in. Like when you're making a ravioli or something that where, you know, when you boil it, it doesn't kind of,
okay,
no filling
so,
is coming out.
So a small amount, otherwise you won't have that space to seal it correctly.
So if you're making your own dumpling wrappers, you don't really need water to kind of go around the edges. But if you're using pre-made wrappers, it's best to kind of, to bind it, to just add a bit of water to the kind of side.
After you've pressed it together, pop some water around.
Well, actually...
Or before.
Before, so you kind of add some water to the
and
side.
And then layer
and
it
then
up.
And then kind of...
Okay, so no egg wash or anything else needed, just
no,
a little bit of water.
That's it, yeah. So then that's your dumpling made. And then cooking it is another thing that's really interesting as well, because what we do is, like, so I've got some boiling water there, and then you just add the dumpling in. So you add all your dumplings in, and then you let it boil again, and then... you add a bit of cold water.
Okay, to reduce it.
Yeah, so you do that 3 times, and then the dumpling will be cooked.
Okay, so initially into the boiling water for how long?
For about like 2-3 minutes until you see it boil up again. And the dumplings tend to float up to the top. And then you add a little bit of cold water to cool it back down. Mm-hmm. And it's so that the dumpling wrapper would cook quite quickly. So you want to make sure that the filling's cooked. So you kind of cool the water down and then you add, let it boil up again and it'll float to the top and you do it 3 times.
Okay, so there is a little process
as opposed to
just scorching it straight away.
How come this dumpling doesn't look as good as your dumpling?
Let's see. Does no, you've done really
maybe
well.
Maybe practice Laura
at the end.
So a nice thing you could do here, so you've combined it, and you can do little pleats to make it even prettier.
I just got a fork and jammed it in, you know, to make those little sort of serrated edge.
Yeah, because you mentioned at the start, Ava,
lovely.
It's the shape of them is symbolic of money, is it?
Yeah, like a Chinese inglot. Like so kind of like a, it's like,
it's
like
it
a shot. Yeah, pop it in. And
that one looks great, Laura.
Thank you. I didn't do that.
It has a fin on it, but
I'm sure it'll taste lovely.
So you wait for this to cook, and then I've also have here some ingredients for making the sauce to go with it. So traditionally, you just have this kind of a Chinese black vinegar, the Jinjiang vinegar, and then I've added a bit of a soy sauce and some of this chili oil.
Oh, lovely. So you've got the vinegar, the soy sauce, and the chili oil, and you put it in this sort of a little ramekin or a bowl for it. Dipping on the side.
And I have some pre-made over there for you guys to try.
Well, we're looking forward to it now.
Okay, shall we head that way then?
You kind of, so you wait for that to boil up and then float to the top and then you add some kind of cold water into it. So you can kind of see, and then you add a little bit of cold water to cool it down and you repeat this process 3 times and then to make sure that the filling of the dumpling is cooked.
Okay, and would boiling them be the most traditional way and your preference, because I did mention earlier,
you were saying that the
steamed
or fried. Yeah. That could absolutely, you know, weed those two. So, like, you can...
They're
like,
okay.
They're,
okay, because that's usually what I get from the takeaway.
Because the thing is, it's really nice, like, because you make loads of dumplings, okay, and then you boil it, and then the next day you could kind of pan fry them. So you can have them both ways.
Just to have that sort of toasted look on either side is lovely as well.
Kind of
bit
nice
of
and crunchy, yeah.
It would be quite nice. And you were saying to us earlier, before we came on, that this is served as a main.
Yeah.
As opposed to getting it as a starter or a side.
Yeah, so you just basically, like, you share and eat lots of different... Because the thing is, you can use lots of different types of filling. So if you wanted to make a vegetarian one, we would use, like, egg, like scrambled egg and chive. Mm. You could make one using tofu mushroom as well.
Oh, lovely, yeah.
Okay. So
whatever you want
very
to put
versatile.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, for now, shall we try the prawn, pork and Chinese chive? Are you going chopsticks, Laura, or fork?
Chopsticks, oh, by right, the way.
Okay. You are thank dexterous,
you.
Are you?
Thanks. Well, would
you like
I don't
sauce?
Know about that.
I'll
yes, love to try some of
like
the dipping sauce.
Sauce. Yeah.
Thank you.
Are you both okay with chili?
We'll find out.
Yeah. I actually haven't, but you know.
I know.
We're going full
thanks,
tradition
Eva.
Here. Thank you, Ava. Okay, mine are sticking together.
So good. You can eat so many of these in one go. That's the problem. They're very Moorish.
Oh, they are beautiful.
Mm. Yeah. Good.
Very good.
Who's going to read that bit? Okay.
Sorry.
Excuse me. We'll get there now in a moment. The Dublin Chinese New Year Festival is taking place in Dublin City at the Fruit and Vegetable Market in the city's Mary's Lane, and that's today and tomorrow.
And the festival runs until the 10th of February, so it's like a 2-week long festival. So there's loads of things to see if you go onto their website, loads of things to see.
We'll take the break. We'll be back in a moment. Recipe details on our website.
Amazing soufflé. Le perfect way. Cooking perfection on Ireland AM. Brought to you by Dodie Trish.